Hello everyone, this is Xander Tiron, and we're here with a kind of a new series, giving it the tentative name of Random Cass. And in this series, I am just going to pull random replays off of the Wargame tool site and cast them. And if anybody complains, well, too bad. When you upload to the tool site, it clearly says that people are going to do stuff like this. So now I'm going to do that stuff that that the site warns you people will do. Anyway, I think this is a ranked game, pretty sure. Anyway, on the blue team we have Markenzwieback what appears to be an Israeli deck. I presume he's running a pure Israeli deck on account of the fact that the replay is entitled All Magland, No Skill, so it should be interesting to see what happens. And on the red team we have Eply, something like that. I'm guessing this is a Eastern Bloc deck, judging by the fact he has a Führungs UAZ. Anyway, let's be on our way. Let's try to avoid the lip smacking. Well, is it all my when I got into the game, all my reset my graphics options, so things are probably gonna look a little bit different. And the frame rate might end up being a little bit wonky throughout the video. Like if I zoom in on a forest, it's not the greatest. That's like 20 frames per second it drops to. Right now it's about 60. Anyway. Let's give him some time. So we got Axarit with Command Infantry. I'm guessing that's going for Echo. We got lots of tracks. Axarits with the grenade launcher squad, I do believe. Or it could be the dragon team, god forbid. Ugh. And we got Zeldas with, I'm guessing that's Rove 90. Hamer with Maglands, I presume. Could be Bedouins. BTR-152 TCM. Looks like P-Code staying back. Akovic's going for Echo, as I said already. We got two more BTR TCMs and some Maglands in the Hamer, I presume. Does Maglan come in the Hamer? I can't remember. Anyway, so I'm guessing those are Conquerors in there. Conquerors M. Got a Snedzka for recon. Strop 2 and a Moderna going middle by the looks of it. Like I said, this might just be there to defend the Führungs UAZ that's going to Charlie by the looks of it. This UAZ staying back. Have an SPW-40 with some variety of recon in it. Couple of BMP-2s. BMP-2s, SPW-80, that's probably going to be... And the BMP-2, I'm guessing that's, words fail me, motor shoots in. Probably 75, could be 90 though. SPW-80, I presume, is some LSTR-40. Some Listerine. And M1 Wilk. Alright, let's see, you got more guys up top here. Ooh, Makurva 3B is out. Along with some more Rove 90, I presume. Yep. Alright, so it's gonna, we got Dracon. And Terran 5 Blazers. And more of these Axarits with grenade launcher teams. And a Ram Recce, I'm guessing that's once again Maglan or Bedouins. And more stuff here in the middle. SPW-40, SPW-80. I can't remember what's in there. Is that the Special Fka from East Germany, I think? LSTR-40, Moderna, Strop 2, Snezka, BMP-1, SP-1. Alright. Yeah, that's the 10.1. And up here, this is... Yep, the 15.1. Anyway. Looks like he hasn't moved these guys yet. Looks like he dropped the Conquerors and is going for some motor shoots and recon infantry. So it looks like they're both going for a substantial... So it looks like it's going to be light presence down the bottom here, but fairly substantial presence in the middle and top. That was actually a fairly significant force going down to Bravo from Markenzwieback. UAZ gets into Charlie right off the bat, so it's giving Eply a plus two, an early plus two lead, though. It won't be significant because that Axorot's going to get into Echo anytime now and unload its command infantry. Alright, so wheels here are moving up pretty fast. So, yep, Maglin's in the Hamers. I'm guessing the same in the Ramrecki. Nope, Bedouin's in the Ramrecki. Alright, Maglin is doing some work. Oh, BMP 1 is actually not being spotted when it's in the river. Alright, oh, Maglin's gonna probably do some work here. Yep, take out the BTR 80. Alright, these Maglins are spotted and taking fire from the BMPs. Ooh, but it takes out one of them. They are worried. Now we got Curva 3B and Zelda's moving in. And, oh, misses the BMP 2. Oh, Conquers and Snazka moving up. Oh, SPW 80 and whatever's in the SPW 40 moving up as well. Has he unloaded one of those? Yep, special off Clara. Alright, good. Givati in the trees. Alright, special off Clara. What's the Givati in? Is the Givati in something? I know, that's probably killing the frame rate and making it unwatchable. Okay, Givati are in the Zeldas, not Rove. Alright, so you got the Messiaitat. Messiaitat? I'm not sure how it's pronounced. I don't speak Hebrew. Alright. Oh, it looks like something bad happened to the Moderna. I'm guessing it got shot up at close range by the Tyrion 5 Blazer while getting perma-stunned by the grenade launchers. Anyway. These mobile shoots aren't shooting up the Givati, though the grenade launcher on the Makarva 3B is causing some trouble. Those, that is mobile shoots in 90, so they got 24 AP power, nothing to sneeze at. Albeit it's fairly short range. That MiG-29 S-13's out. Is that the East German one? I can info it. Nope, Polish one, so it has semi-active missiles. Yep, R-27Rs, not R-77s. Anyway. Special Clara getting wrecked by transports and grenade launchers. Nope. More Givati moving down the middle, though they're probably going to have a bad time at the hand of those Conquerors. Well, Conquers M, to be specific. Messiaet is going shot. Is it shooting up the Snezhka? Yep, shooting up the Snezhka. Those LSTR-40 are rushing in. With the RPG-29, they can do a lot of damage to a Blazer. Yeah, 24 AP. That's, yeah, it's going to one-shot it from the front, as you just saw. Grenade launcher still doing a lot of damage before going down to a shot from the Moderna and BMP-1. Curva 3B moving in from the top. That's gonna leave a mark. Oh boy, that's harsh. Strap 2 is pulling back. Not surprising. MiG-29-9-13S. Bit of a mouthful. Curva 2A moving in. I always say Makurva, it's not Makava. I don't know why. I'm weird like that, I guess. Anyway. A solid defensive line from Markenzwieback here in Bravo. Jesus. Three MiG-58s and a Browning and a MiG-58. So the Zelda has a little bit more firepower than the Axorot. However, only two front and side versus 10 front, 6 side. It's a bit of a trade-off. That and Zelda is 5 points. Yep. Axorot is 15. Alright, Conquers firing on the Ramrecki and loses line of sight thanks to the trees. Bedouins and Givati in the tree line here. Looks like they'll be joined by some more Bedouins. This Makava 3B took a hit from something. You didn't see what it was. Probably got shot from the front by the LSTR 40. See, 24 AP versus 21 front. That'll do a fair bit of damage. Oops, here 30. Shot up something, I didn't see it. These guys are almost out of missiles. Alright, got Granatomets moving in by the looks of it. Because that's the check one. Yep, So I'm guessing out of Grenadnomets, or whatever it's pronounced, the AGS-13 team. And more BMP-2s with motor shoots in. Alright. I avoid clearing my throat right to the microphone. Alright, that's the regular supply truck. Yep, 15.800 liters. Cheap and cheerful. Looks like this stumbled upon some grenade launchers. And that is... motor shoots in 90 in the BMP-2s. That's, what, 20 points? 35 points, it's not bad. Oh. I say that they're gonna have a bad time at the end of the BMP-2. Or the two BMP-2s. Yep. Oh, Syria 30 is out. I'm not sure what it's going for. It looks like he's probably going to try and spot the Makava. Or it spotted something. Maybe the 2A was spotted? Nope. Come on, it's a map. What was that? Wait, just wait for the effects to subside so I don't completely kill the frame rate. Ram Recce. I can't help but feel that maybe wasn't the best use of the Syria 30, because now it's going to be... Oh, Shayatet engaging the motor shoots in. And the AGS-17s. Grenadomet, however it's pronounced. Oh. Maglan's doing some more work. Machine guns turn off on the Maglan, and what that does is it basically forces them to use the Spike MR. Otherwise, if they're infantry in range, they'd be shooting at the infantry with the machine gun if they see the infantry before vehicles. Yeah, that Makava was spotted. Anyway, so yeah, it's just... I can't help but feel that I was a bit of a... not a very good use of the Syria 30 to take out that Ram Recce. Because that Merkava 3B was spotted for a bit, and it might have been able to get, that Syria 30 might have been able to get a side shot, which would have instantly killed the Merkava. Otherwise, I think two hits with 30 AP missiles will kill anything, any tank in the game from the front, if I recall correctly. Okay, big 29 flying about. Well, looks like the Gavadi might be doing some probing down here in Bravo. Both of them have their plus two objective, and it doesn't look like they're going to try and secure any of their flank objectives or the middle objective. So, yep, no. Marken is bringing out a M325P code for Bravo, which will give him a plus one. Yeah, Eply here is not a very good position to try and get a commander to golf, especially with the Gavadi flanking around that he doesn't know about, presumably. Anyway. Yeah, he's in a fairly tenuous position here in Foxshot and Gulf. Oh, what's this? No, it's okay, it's just a MiG-29. Nope, Moderna out. What, the same Moderna from before? I think, no, it's a different Moderna. I think he lost his first Moderna. Didn't see it happen, though. Let's see. The last time I saw it, it was somewhere in here. Getting out after getting shreked by a Turan 5. A Turan, not a Turan. I'm a Turan, not a Turan. Unless I am a Turan. Ah, it doesn't matter, because I'm just talking nonsense about, you know, my username. Oh, Gavadi flanked around, took... Yep, that's... Bravo is going to be pretty secure for Markin now. Alright. Mouth is a little bit dry, I need some water. Oh, map pad's moving in. That's a long range ITO with two more AP. Yep, Gavadi. Took out something. They're an 85? Yes, they are. Oh, looks like that BMP-2 was detected, and that's why the Lahatut went for it. Though it looks like it missed because it's taking ground fire, and the Maglan's Took out the BMP too. Yeah, ultimately doesn't matter though. Alright. Looks like Eply is trying to get a better position here in Foxtrot. Pair of LSTR 40 holding out here in Foxtrot. Ooh, they're gonna, if they hit, they'll do, yeah, they did a lot of damage to that Makava. Though are they gonna get another shot in before they get wrecked? Yep. They do finish off the Makava. And they're, oh, or Sirith. Ooh, MI-17 coming out. Yep, putting lots of fire in with those rockets, but now it's taking ground fire from the Gavati. Oops, gonna get, it's gonna engage in with the 122s. And with the rockets. Oh. Nesher A coming out with the hydropods. Oh, MiG-29 is out. Looks like he's gonna bomb the Gavati. Is it going to get missiles off at the Nesher? That's her. Nope. MiG-29 S-13 is out. MiG-29-913S. I can never say that right. Alright, MI-17 is dropping down in Foxtrot now. Gavati take a big hit from the MiG-29 at those thermobaric bombs. Oh, it looks like Eply forgot about the Granatomets in here. I want to unload them before something unfortunate happens. But Durna is getting pretty aggressive. You want to be careful that if it goes too far, it's going to get be vulnerable to a side shot from the Makava. My cat wants me to go in bed, apparently. And yeah, that's not good for the Moderna. It's just going to engage at close range with the 3B. Oops, here 30 tried to do a attack. While set of target is now taking heavy fire. Yep, it's down. BTR has stunned it. Draken finished it off. That's a pretty big loss for Eply, because that's like, what, 130, 140 point plane? You don't want to lose those. Okay. Command infantry on the deck. Not quite sure where they're going to be going, though. Oh. Granatomets moving out in the open. Looks like Eply's going to move them to try and keep these Gavati under control. LSTR-40 engaging Gavati up here. Probably not going to end well for the LSTR-40. They're not bad, but it's just, they don't have a machine gun, so even though the carbine's pretty good, or carbine, however you want to pronounce it, it's pretty good. It's a good carbine. As you see, it has the super stats. It's not enough to make up for a lack of machine gun, especially against a 15-man squad like Gavati. Now they're going to be engaged by some Shayetet 13. Yeah, it's just not good. Nope, another bombing run coming out. That's probably going to do a fair bit of damage if it is well placed. Takes out the Gavati. Shayetet do escape almost entirely unscathed. And they're more than a match for LSTR, especially if they're out in the open like that. Okay. Rove 90 engaging. Rove 8. Nope, BTR engaging the MI-17. That's gonna... that's harsh. Anyway, moving on. Really not much else here, just some LSTR getting massacred. Serves them right. Oh, MiG-29-912A is out again. Looks like it might do some damage, depending on where he dropped. If you dropped them more forward, it could do a lot of damage. Nope, you dropped them right in the tree, so yeah, they're gonna fall short. Yeah, if you know your enemy, the enemy's gonna be moving his infantry, you wanna try and predict where they're gonna be when you do a attack position. Alright, oh, looks like he has a couple of them. Looks like he's probably gonna be dropping right on the buildings, I'm guessing. Oh. Gavati get shrecked. That should do a fair bit of damage. Yep. Nope. Pair of M1 Wilkes come out. Frong's UAZ is out. It looks like he did move his command squad into Foxtrot. However, I didn't point it out, but Markenzwieback did move a command vehicle into Golf. So that is giving him a +1 ladies now at 79 points to Eply's 20. And Marken has a very good control over Bravo with a fairly significant force there, so it's going to be pretty hard for Eply to try and influence Bravo, so his best bet is Golf. If he can take out the CV and Golf, that's going to give him a... depends. If he countercaps it, that's going to even out the point acquisition. If he can take out the CV, that will give him plus one. However, that's easier said than done. His best bet to do that would be to send a forest flanking through the forest here and hope that it can overpower these vehicles here quickly enough that the forces down here won't be able to react in time before the P code is taken out. Once again, easier said than done. Now, Masayat going in. That's going to be trouble. Yep. Furong's UAZ moving in. That's going to countercap, which will equal out the point loss for Eply. MI2 looks like it's just going to be watching up here. Not much happening here. Yep. I say Golf is going to be the decisive... Where's what a decisive battle shall be? Looks are pretty fun. Got a 9 round per minute autoloader. Decent armor. Decent AP. It's a solid 85 point tank. Yep, enough. I'm moving around. That's just empty transport, though. Nothing interesting. Oh, BM-27. That's the explosive? Nope, it's the cluster. Alright. I'm guessing he's going to drop into the forest here and try to do some damage there. Grenade launcher team versus grenade launcher team. Looks like the grenades got the first shot off, so these guys were all stunned. Oh, looks like Messayat are going to get their turn though, and Axart are going to shred those infantry. Now the Wilkes are in point blank range, so they're going to one-shot those transports. Now if it's John, it's probably going to try and shoot down the MI2 with its machine gun. Yep. That's what I thought. He's firing clusters into that forest. I didn't see if it took anything out. Probably just transports, if it did hit anything. Anyway. Oops, Netska engaging Maglands. Oh, big 2912A going out. Looks like one dropped. The other one must have lost sight of target. It must have been a direct attack. So now it's flying around in the back. Oop, took a hit from the Drake, and it's probably going to go down. Yep, BTRs are going to finish it off. Oh, actually, it manages to make it out. Oh, he must have forgotten about it. Because it's... Oh, is it going to make it out? Is that MiG-29 going to... MiG-29 makes it out. Wow, that's good. Now, motor shoots in are going out with the Gavati. Oh, no. Now this thing's taking heavy fire. Oh, Barak is out. The MiG-29 913S makes it out. Yep. So yeah, now Markin knows that. Eply's trying to move through the top here, so he's definitely gonna reinforce. Send reinforcements here, so his command is safe. You know, something I never do when I'm on this map. See, this is why I'm doing this random cast, because, so you can see what, you know, slightly higher level play than what I engage in looks like. Also, I'm doing this because I really didn't feel like playing the game, but I wanted to do something Red Dragon related. Oop. Messayant, take a big hit there. Next shot that he takes, yep. Oh, Makava 2A moving in. Those Wilkes are in trouble. They're going to get a Makava from the front and some Shayat 13 from the rear. That is not going to be pleasant for them. Because that's got 21 AP versus... Yeah, it's going to be a one-shot. There goes one. This one's turning to engage. It took a big hit from the Makava. It's, yeah. Not good. Oh, new SC. Is that the tracked one? Nope, it's the wheeled one. It's not particularly fast. Has pretty good autonomy, though. Oh, that did a bombing run. Guess it's up in here. Yep, but Olympic sprinter Shayette 13 do get out of there in time. Now we have a Barak doing a constant air patrol. I think that MiG-29 got shot down. But not by the Barak, because it's, you know, full ammunition load. Right, saying the new is not bad. You have two options. You have a tracked one, which is has some armor, but it's pretty slow and has bad, not very good autonomy, if I recall correctly. Versus this one, which is not particularly fast for a wheeled vehicle, but it has no armor, but it does have 10 HP, so it's still vulnerable to enemy counterfire, such as mortars being the big one. Oh, Maglan spot and take out a supply vehicle. Let's see, yeah. Yep. Oh, MiG-29-13S moving out to engage the Barak 2 by the looks of it. Nope, it looks like it's just there to do a constant air patrol. He did turn on the NUA, though. Looks like he's going to try. Looks like his plan was to try and get the Barak to engage the MiG. Yeah, he's saying on MiG-29-12A. Looks like he might try and force the Barak to move over into his air defense network. Oh, Barak's evacing. MiG-29S is shooting. Ooh, it's kind of. Looks like. Nope. Flew over the MiG-29 flew over the air defense network and goes down. It's unfortunate. It's pretty unlucky there with all those missiles missing the Barak. Then again, Barak does have fairly high ECM, it's like 40%. Which doesn't mean it's exceptional. Oh, something happened here, wasn't paying attention. Wasn't there, oh yeah, there's motor shoots in special of Clara over here. Must have tried moving them across and they got shot up. Or not. I could just be imagining things. Wouldn't it be the first for me? Anyway. Doesn't matter. Ew, Eisherman's moving up. Looks like they're going to go down the middle. Yeah, he knows the motor shoots in there and those Eisherman's will be able to do a lot of damage to them. You want to see? 3 HE, 8 rounds per minute. I can do a lot of damage. Well, okay. Oh, there he goes. The MedPats are shooting ATGMs at these BMP-1s. And it hits. Looks like there's one missile left. Yep. These Shayetet are moving around. I think they were spotted at some point, or those OT-62As are just moving there now. And it looks like he's trying to use these guys as a roadblock, you know, angry speed bump to defend the Furong's UAZ. Oh no, Granada Met's moving in. He going to want to unload those before bad things happen. Oh no, they're dead. So now he's moving to engage. MiG-29 coming out. Yep. Oh, Ramrecki going on an adventure though. I think he might have a bad time at the head of that Snedzka. Oh, looks like that might be a good hit. Oh no, it misses. But it does force him to go around. Oh, Granatomet's moving out. Ricky's moving in. BM-27's about to fire. On what? I'm not sure. He might be trying to go for a CV sniper if he's going to fire it into the back here. Yep, Snedzka whacks the ram. Eisherman's moving in. Looks like they gib the motor shoots in there. Oh, he's firing into the air. Don't know how much damage that's going to do, though. Not a lot. Yeah, it's 4 top armor versus 5 AP. It's not going to be doing a lot of damage whatsoever. Oh. UAZ was taken out. No, okay, UAZ moved. Like, oh, where'd it go? Yep. Ooh, those Wilks, however, could do a lot of damage. Is it a heat gun? It is a heat gun, so it's going to be doing 1 damage every time to those Wilks, and that's going to build up over time. Alright. Got, yep, Mo shoots in Wilk. That should be enough. Yep. Those Eye Shermans are gonna go down in no time. Good counter move from Eply there. Oh, LSTR-40. Nope. Versus MiG to A. I mean, MiG Merkava to A. Oh, those grenade launch. That grenade launcher is absolutely doing an absolute number on him. Oh dear. That's. Should put like a trigger warning there. Need to give a warning before you see a brutal rape like that. And that's not something that's really not a. Wow. I think that's the first time I can ever recall using rape in relationship to a video game in, like, forever. I'm just gonna move on from this topic now. Alright. So, like, Markenzwieback has had this plus 1 point lead for a while now, so he's at 244 conquest points to Eply's 20. Wilk's getting trekked by Makavas at close range. These all have grenade launchers on them. Map Hat's shooting at the BMP, I guess. Or it could be shooting at the Wilk and it just missed. Drop 2, taking out the map hats. These guys getting wrecked by grenade launchers and cannon fire. And machine gun. Maglands ready to do some work. At some point, the UAZ was taken out. I'm guessing it was due to a Maglan-related incident. That's now given Markenzwieback a plus 2 lead. Barak is out, it's still out. It's going after a MiG-912A, flies over the Nua. Oh, Nua does take it out. There we go, watch it crash into the ground. Boom, headshot. Anyway. Oh, Magak 7C Gimel, holding down there, that's 100.1. Shayet are being very angry back here. Oh man, how many times I'm going to say back? Oh, Moderna. I think that's his last Moderna. He's going to get like 3 of those in a deck, I do believe. Okay, Shayet had in the open, taking heavy fire. Oh, second Barak is out. I do believe that is Israel. Because Israel, I think, gets 2 Baraks. Doesn't matter. Oh. The Nua was spotted and taken out. Oh, another BM-27 coming out from Eply. It's probably going to fire into the forest again. Yep, bring out another Nua. More Shayet moving in. Yep, those B-300s are pretty powerful. Oh, Granatomet firing on him. It's panicked one of them. More Granatomets there. Maglan moving up the top here. Strop takes out... Or is that this? Yeah, it's one of Israel's, I do believe. I can just examine the wreck. Yep, that's Israel. Looks like it's a Nesser, I'm guessing. Nesher. The Mirage, with the Mirage variant with the rocket pods. Ooh, what's this? Nesher A out over here. Curious. Whatever SPZ stands for, I'm not quite sure. Not Sperrpanzer, I know that. Sternpanzer, maybe? I don't know. I'd have to look that up. Makava's about to wreck some fools. Or may just give Adi, who knows. Markenz at 346 conquest points. He has a plus 2 lead. He is currently counter-capping. I didn't point it out, but he's counter-capping Foxtrot. which is why he has a plus 2 lead. NS2R40 is taking heavy fire. Gavati is moving up. Oh my. Looks like they're going to be engaging the motor shoots in here. But they are supported by BMP-2s. Oh, Moderna is also giving them some support. Oh, two BM-27s firing. And he's trying to snipe the CV and Echo. Unfortunately for him, he's first of all targeting the wrong spot. And second of all, that is a infantry command, which is not going to take any damage whatsoever from that, from those cluster munitions. MiG-29 912A out. Guess he's going for the Gavati. Looks like he's gonna avoid any ground fire. Yep, heavy damage to the Gavati. Motor shoots in 90 are taking a beating from the Makava, though. Lots of Makava. Or whatever the plural form is. Oh, second BM-27's firing. Looks like he actually has the right spot. Or not, nope, looks like he's firing it over here. Yep. Anyway. Bedouins engaging with the M14. Like they're shooting up some LSTR-40. Yep. Oh, looks like they missed, or they just didn't do enough damage due to the forest damage bonus. There we go. Anyway, Rove engaging the motor shoots in 90 at close quarters. BMP-2 taking heavy fire, MI-17 trying to do some supporting fire. Maglens, no. Maglens going out at some special Jagnocti and some grenade mats by the looks of it. Oh, Kernas with the... Oh, Kernas went down. I think a MiG went down as well. Let's see, that's... buried in the terrain. And the one over here. Over here, that's a MiG-29, so yeah. Looks like he traded a MiG-29 for a laser-guided bomber. Looks like the LGBs were going for these guys here. Maglans are in trouble. Those Specialini Jednotki are pretty tough. And with support from the Granatomet, they should be able to take out the Maglans no problem. Anyway, oh, push coming here from Markenzwieback. Gavati drawing fire in the open. Magok-7C Gimel take shooting up anything that shoots back. Markenzwieback's got 454 conquest points. Looks like it shall not be much longer. MI-17 cruising about. Looks like he's going to try and take out these guys. And, I mean, Markenzwieback doesn't really have any anti-air. Wow, that's one. Yep. Two rockets. That's a lot of damage. Is he going to try and engage the Gavati or the Magok with the MI-17? I personally would go for the tank. Aiming at something. Nope, going for the Gavati. And only has two rockets left. Oh, wow, PT-91 Twardy is out. Interesting choice. Two cards of Veneer Super Heavies between the Moderna and the Twardy, the PT-91. They're fairly... I'd say the Moderna is slightly better than the Twardy. That's my opinion. It has better armor. It has, I think it has slightly better ammunition. Nope. MiG-29 and Brock trade. Twardy's continuing to move up. It's the Polish kind of. It's not a super heavy, it's a near super heavy, and that is game. Markenzwieback won after accumulating the 500 conquest points needed to win. Eply only got 20. Markenzwieback won with 3,215 kills to 2,045 losses. Alright, post-battle analysis. Let's break it down. Blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to say Israel OP or anything like that. However, I'd say Markenzwieback won the battle on account of, I say he definitely used the units to his strength. He spammed out a lot of those Makavas with the grenade launchers, which allows them to wreck basically everything. Because grenade launchers need to be reworked so much. It's not even funny how ridiculous grenade launchers are in this game. Or automatic grenade launchers, I should say. Oh, need some water. Okay. Anyway, what else to say? Eply didn't really play his tanks very well. He was kind of over aggressive with his moderners. Hi, cat. Anyway, as I was saying before my cat interrupted, Eply was pretty aggressive with his modernas, and it definitely cost him his tanks. I have to double check. I think you get three of them in a Eastern Bloc deck. If I can find one. Yeah, whatever. Let's see. What is going on with this deck? Why do I not have any super heavies in it? Apparently this is the wrong deck to look at. I want to look at a Eastern Bloc deck. There we go. So you get three Modernas. And yeah, he seemed to have an interesting, because I know he had Moderna, I know he had M1 Wilk, and he also had Twardy. So he had at least three tanks. I don't know. Let's compare Twardy and Moderna. So, Twardy has slightly better accuracy and stabilizer, 60% and 50 versus 55 and 45. And has 22 AP, which is pretty respectable. However, and all else, it has 9 rounds per minute, 60 kilometers an hour, 20 frontal armor, 10 side, 4 back, 4 top, versus Moderna with 55, 45, 23. That's an important number. It allows it to do a fair bit of damage. And 8 rounds per minute, so slightly slower shooting. But also, the thing to keep in mind is the Moderna is 70 kilometers an hour, which is pretty fast for a tank. Has one more frontal armor and one more back armor. Back armor is not hugely relevant, because anything that shoots in the back is going to, if not one shot, it's going to do massive damage on either tank. And what else is... not a lot else to say. Words escape me. Yeah, I'd say that for 5 points more, the Moderna is definitely a lot better. It has, slightly worse fire control and slightly lower rate of fire. However, it's just that AP plus that frontal armor, not to mention the autocannon, makes it very good against basically any target. It gives it, it makes it, the autocannon's a lot better against infantry than a 50 caliber machine gun. And I'd say it's in a Eastern Bloc deck, you take either the Moderna or the Twardy. You don't take both of them usually. I'd say it'd be better off taking the M2 Wilk for 120 points. Now it gives you respectable frontal armor and respectable AP power with all right accuracy. Are the Twardy and the M2 Wilk like the same unit with different colors? It looks like it. I'm gonna be right. Yeah. See, I need to turn my model quality up. so I can get a better comparison. Yeah, I've crap computer. Everything looks like crap. Alright, not really. This game is actually fairly well optimized, I would say. That's the reason why I can run it without my... I can run the game and record it without too many difficulties. Too much difficulty. Let's see. This should look slightly better. Nope, still looks not very good. Eh, doesn't matter. This is really just pointless filler at the end of the video. Yeah, anyway, back to the battle. Yes, I'd say that Markenzwieback used the strengths of the Israeli deck to his advantage, obviously. He, you know, spread those maglands about, he used those, you know, machine gun laden transports, he used those grenade launchers, and he spread them about, and that gave him a pretty good position. Combined that with Eply being a little over aggressive at points with his tanks meant that Eply's Eastern Bloc infantry, which is very solid, you know, don't get me wrong, Eastern Bloc has very good infantry choices. It's just that without vehicle support, they're hopeless against enemy vehicles. And I guess that's all I have to say. Yep, that's all I'm going to say. I'm Xander Tyron, and this was Random Cast.